Bonjour Roland.
Bonjour David.
Ça va bien?
Ça va bien.
Bonjour Roland.
Super temps.
How are you today? Fine.
Aujourd'hui, Chardonnay Day. Préparation
Great weather. So cool with you today about Chardonnay. As we're preparing together Chardonnay Day.
Et donc, l'idée, c'est de se rencontrer, de discuter un petit peu et qu'on
parle ensemble. The idea is to talk with you about this great variety of Chardonnay. To know more about your feelings about it and how it takes a big part in the success of the various wines of the Hospice de Beaune, those famous 45 cuvées. I chose to do this interview in a very specific plot. Can you tell us more about it? We have the feet in the heart and magic of Burgundy terroir. We are on the hill of Corton, on a tiny plot called Le Charlemagne. This is a very good place for Chardonnay, for the appellation Corton Charlemagne. Maybe you don't see it easily, but our ancestors, the old winemakers of the Hospice de Beaune, they actually understood where to plant Chardonnay. Corton is one of the most famous Burgundy appellations, with something specific about it. It produces both white and red wines. You seem to say that depending on the side of the hill, people had already noticed where each varietal is at its best. It is a round-shaped hill, and vines are planted all around this hill. Part of it is planted with Chardonnay, and it's called Corton Charlemagne Grand Cru. And part of it is planted with Pinot Noir, and then called Corton Renard or Corton Bressan Grand Cru, for instance. Here we are on the southwest slope, the best for the Chardonnay.
D'accord. Est-ce que, en termes de justement de sol, de type de sol, de
Can you tell me what kind of soil do we have here? Is it limestone?
Est-ce que c'est les caractéristiques physiques qui donnent aussi cette capacité?
Il y a l'orientation, il y a aussi bien sûr puisque c'est quand même le
problème. Orientation is very important. La position du sol, donc effectivement. The soil too is very important, as this is what creates a terroir. Soil is limestone mainly, but the limes are not the same everywhere on the hill, depending on altitude and orientation. This explains why Chardonnay is more suited here than Pinot Noir. Of course, we could still make great Pinot Noir vines here, but that's why Burgundy is so special.
Les blancs sont positionnés dans tel et tel terroir, c'est ancestral et c'est vérifié, ça se vérifie encore.
It's a long tradition and it's a now that we keep today. This plot produces one of the most famous cuvées of the Hospice de Bonne Auction. Yes, Corton Charlemagne Grand Cru, cuvée François de Salins. One of the eldest and also one of the most expensive white Burgundies of the Hospice de Beaune. François de Salins is the father of Guigon de Salins, who founded the Hôtel Dieu, the hospital, in Beaune in 1443. So this name means that this vineyard is one of the eldest ones that belongs to the Hospice estate. Yes, that's true. It does not mean that the vines are this old. The vines are about 40 years old and of very good quality for production of wine.
Justement, ce cépage Chardonnay, est-ce que en Bourgogne,
Chardonnay is born in Burgundy. You had the opportunity to taste Chardonnay wines from all over the world. What do you find here that you don't see in other wine regions, in some other parts of the world?
C'est une banalité, je veux dire, mais bon, c'est la complexité, quoi.
Well, I think it's obvious, but to me, I think that complexity is the key word. Varietal is the same, but the result is different, because terroir is different in Burgundy. We have a very complex, a very rich terroir. Complex soil, a kind of microclimate, and you don't have it anywhere else. They said there are some very good Chardonnays in many places all over the world because Chardonnay is easy to cultivate and it pleases easily. It's easy to understand. It's a varietal that adapts easily to. It adapts to a lot of different terroirs. Is it also its taste that made Chardonnay so popular? Is it maybe its aromas? And how would you describe Chardonnay's aromas? Well, in Burgundy's complexity, definitely. A rich side, finesse and elegance are the key words that describe it. Compared to some other varietals. What is this elegance? Well, in the mass, that is an olfactory complexity, a great length, some power and regularity year after year, that's important. In places where Chardonnay is less suited, we produce a more floral and fruit-driven wine with less elegance. So there's kind of opposition, a duality between varietal aromas and terroir aromas. Oh, exactly. You said it better than me. This plot on which we're on, how big is it? It's about half an hectare. We make an average 7 to 8 barrels every year in Appellation Canton Charlemagne Grand Cru. What's the average price at the auction? Last year, I think it was about 20,000 euros. It's definitely on the top of the range, I see. Is the tasting of this cuvée of Canton Charlemagne different? How special is it? Do you work it differently in terms of viticulture and winemaking? Well, first of all, as a proof of its Grand Cru level, we're on a spot where the grapes ripen quite slowly. It's not an early plot. We need to wait for the grapes to be perfectly ripe. We need to wait for that quite a long time. And this means that the alcohol degree, when compared to other places like the United States, where they've got degrees at 15 or 16 degrees of sugar, here we are about at 13 to 13.5 maximum degrees. It's a good sign. It means a slow ripening process for the fruit, which in turn means complex aromas. But then there's nothing really special about the winemaking and vinification. What is specific about Chardonnay on this terroir is that it doesn't express itself very much when it's young. It's almost closed at the beginning. It's rather a closed wine with very mineral and slightly bitter with very complex aromas with very good length too. It does not explode on the nose or in the mouth. It needs to age, to mature slowly in the cellar. I understand it's a long-term wine to keep for something like 30 or 40 years. Oh yes. What's the oldest Canton Charlemagne you've tasted? It was not that old, it was about 25 years old. How was it? Well, it was very good with aging aromas like acacione. It had lost its acidity, obviously, and it was a very round wine with a good presence in the mouth. The kind of wine you could drink with fish, obviously, but also with cheese or even just for a drink. I was about to talk about it. I know you like to eat good things, like many people in Burgundy. What food and wine pairings do you suggest with Chardonnay and with this Canton Charlemagne? There are two types of Chardonnays, I think. Those who come from regional Bourgogne appellations, and they're on the freshness and acidity side. They're very good with seafood or starters, not too much vinegar in it. And that's the majority of the Chardonnays that we produce in Burgundy. That's about 85%, something like that. And then there are the Chardonnays from the Grand Cru or Premier Cru or prestige appellations like Canton Charlemagne with good aging potential. And those are perfect with creamy dishes, with cheese too.
Okay. par exemple, un vieux coton Charlemagne sur un bleu ou sur
For instance, ou sur an old coton Charlemagne with blue cheese or not too much cheeses is great, really.
Super plaisir.
It's one of the memories I've got. We did this with some Americans a while ago, pairing an old bâton Montrachet with regional cheeses. Delicious. They were quite surprised, but it was really delicious. Chardonnay goes well with many dishes.
D'accord. Dernière question. Aujourd'hui, donc, on est début mai.
One last question, Roland.
Quasiment milieu du mois de
mai. We are in the middle of May.
On est au milieu du mois de mai.
How is the vine doing at this stage and in this vintage? I think we're quite in advance in 2011.
Pas complètement, parce que je viens d'expliquer.
Yes, it's flower time here. This terroir, as I said, is a little bit cold, so the flower is not done everywhere, but it's going steadily. Flower time is key stage, key phase for the vine, yes. Oh yes, it's very important. After flower, the grapes are formed, so we know that we'll harvest in 3 months from now. So this means end of August, yes. Harvest end of August, 2011. You're saying that on early vintages, Chardonnay behaves differently. Oh yes, that's something we discover. We discover new behaviors with the climate change. In Australia or California, they know that. Here it is something new, with a quick ripening stage that lasts only a few days, just before harvest. A bit like in 2003? Yes, 2003, 2006. We'll see.
Parce que justement, 2007 était un millésime précoce, et à contrario,
you know, 2007 was early too, but Chardonnay didn't ripen quite well. So we'll see, we don't know. It's going to be very interesting. It should ripen in good conditions, but we'll see if it's like in 2007 or like 2003, for instance. We'll see. Okay, so let's meet again next September.